Hey guys, it's Remrats, and today I'm gonna be doing some American Truck Simulator. It's like episode 3 now. So I'm just gonna go pick up a load at Wells. So right now, the first thing to talk about is the modding in Emergency 4 right now. So I'm more prioritized on Corona at the moment, and Bushton's sort of the next thing that I'm gonna do once I'm done with that. Okay, so turn here. Okay, it shouldn't be too long of a trip. It's a few hours, 4.5 hours in game. Like, it's just like an trailer or a box trailer. Also, I'll be working on making a mods list for all the mods that I use in American Truck Simulator soon. I'll also be making a Dropbox link or some other sort of alternate link for all my mods that I have out, because I've had some people complain about Mega not working, so I'm trying to get that fixed. Okay, I'm just gonna end the trailer, so looks like we're gonna go to Winnemucca? I guess so, I guess that's how you say it. I don't know why this adds so much extra distance. Weird. So we'll go through Elko. It's weird because I thought I discovered Elko. Alright, yeah, so I've been going through Nevada recently. And it's the shortest. I think that today during this episode I'll mainly be talking about modding in Emergency 4. And I'll get out to the highway first because I can't really drive that great when I'm talking. So I'm focusing on talking. I really like Wells. It's a cool little town. It's got a nice scenery. It's a weird trailer because you don't really notice it when you're doing stuff. Unless it's not like right here. And this is not my normal truck. I usually use a 379. That's what I do. But I got this one recently and I kind of like it. This is like my first time with it. This is modded. The bumper is modded and it's got low beams on the bottom. Yeah, we should be actually able to get some night driving done. I got custom stacks on it. Wheels are stock, I see stuff. The mirror, passenger mirror is stock. Custom. Oh, I got some. Oh, I didn't watch out. I definitely drive a lot. I keep doing that. I've been doing that recently where I just keep looking at it and then I hit somebody. I think I don't know. I plan with the modding stuff. I think I might. I'm gonna start, like, putting out some tutorials for modding at some point. Because I think that I'm probably gonna end up. I mean, I'll probably put out Bushden 4 and then work on Corona, and once that's kinda done, I'll probably stop doing modding. Because it's just sort of really time consuming to me, and I'm not as interested in the emergency anymore. And the main reason I still play it is so I can get the videos out. And that's what is the main sort of video is that you can watch on this show. So. Dude, I've been having red tires. I saw something about that before. Yeah, it's really light because it's not. No, it's zero. Lots of trucks parked there. Actually, I had to stop at one of these. I'm also using the MHA Pro right now. So, this isn't going to be on the stop. Part of this isn't going to be on the stock map. I'm actually going to start doing edits to it. Like a personal sort of edits to it. It won't be. It'll be private, but I'll just do some stuff about it probably. I like the Nevada though. The speed limits are a lot higher here. I don't get why. Actually also a that they would make the light cycle is more realistic in this game. Because it's 7:50 in the game. And it's still pretty sunny at like 9. In real life, even if it wasn't dark right now, it would be pretty close. The sun would be close to setting. And it wouldn't be that high up. I don't get why that was such longer. Yeah, I've also been noticing recently that in American Truck Simulator, I get like it'll sort of, I don't know how to describe it. It's like these weird waves on the screen. I'm not sure if that shows up in the recording, but I've been noticing that it'll happen every once in a while. And I think that's the fact that I don't have VSync on, so the frame rates are just too high, and it starts doing that. But the problem is that if I turn on VSync, then if I turn on VSync, then my frame rate will drop because it's doing that extra processing. So I've just kind of dealt with it. If I can find another short trip, I might do that, because it seems like it's been sort of just a really short episode. It's only been like 15 minutes so far. 10:15. So, we'll see. This guy needs to stop. I noticed that the one thing about the MHA Pro that they do a lot is that at these drop-off zones, they add a lot of extra stuff around, so it's kind of harder to maneuver. So what I'm going to try and do is make sort of an edgy turn right now. Try and let jackknife. Then I'm going to back in. At this point, it's sort of hard to stop the jackknife. Luckily there's no load on there, it'd be in the back of my cab probably. So now I can start backing it up. I'm probably coming in too close. Oh, let me go drop this delivery off at a loading bay when there's nothing on it. There's some sort of thing, but I guess that really works. I kind of wish you could buy your own trailer though. That's one of the things that I really wanted. So it'd be nice to be able to get your own trailer, customize it, and pick up what you wanted to haul. I able to make it out without hitting the horn. I'll just sneak right up here. Best at parking them, but I can get them done. It's all about the approach, really, because if you don't have the right approach, then you can't really do it. $4,000. I've got 255 experience. Alright, let me check my jobs. I think Battle Mountain or Dermot. Alright, so I think that I might try to get a shorter load. Possibly. So I'm gonna go head over to the rest stop and just, or whatever, hotel, and make him go to sleep because I have 2 hours in game time until he starts sleeping, so get some day trucking in so I can see it. I like night trucking because there's not really much traffic, you know, you just don't see much of the scenery, and if you're doing a lot of stuff, it's fine. Because I haven't really been touching a lot of yet. That's sort of not the best condition, so if you want to check it out. I really like Las Vegas though, because I've been there once or twice, and it's kind of nice scenery. I'm pretty excited for Arizona. I really like Arizona. See that it's got the red wheels, and then I'll kind of fix itself. So let's see what we have today. Alright, so I think we're gonna go take a quick load of cars to Elko. Maybe we could take them to Reno. There's much up there above Reno. Alright, here's some stuff. So I'm gonna head to Reno. I haven't used that trailer much. Let's see. back out of the spots. If you just saw a couple seconds before, you could see the screen waves. And there it happens again. Sometimes it's really apparent, and sometimes it's kind of just like, barely notice it. For some reason, this truck has a really fast acceleration, which kind of annoys me. Have a little bit, but yeah, if you look at those bushes, when I'm driving, it starts to get all weird on the bushes. Everybody's slowing down because I have my hazards on. I like Nevada. It's nice. There's a big chain from California. Is that like California? About if I have the time to do it, because I don't always have the time. So, yeah. There's a plane overhead. That's in my eye. Don't stop. Not right now, it's out. lot of that. Once it comes out, I'll definitely be heading over there and doing a road trip. Because I really like Arizona. I noticed there's not always left-hand turns, and I think that's because some of these are, I don't know, maybe it is. Yeah, almost there. I don't think I'm gonna park it just because of the video length. It's been like 35 minutes, so. Not make it too long. I'm gonna stop before I make my right. Sometimes I'll get a little bit of lag if I'm in a city, especially when it's modded. But I mean, it's better than what I used to have, but only inside, so. I'm happy to crank up the settings to max and still be at 60 FPS most of the time. Yeah, like here, there's no left-hand turn signal. When I do my private thing, I might end up doing something like that. Like, actually putting those in. That's so cool. And I surely love how they've done that to the game, right? Wait, it's a really big Walmart. I said I'll do it, so. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please like and subscribe and comment if you have any feedback or ideas. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.